لو أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا
الله. الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور انفسنا ومن سيئات اعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، واشهد ان محمدا رسول الله. All praise and gratitude is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We seek His help and His forgiveness, and we seek refuge with Allah from the evil of our own souls and from our bad deeds. Whomsoever Allah guides will never be led astray, and whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala leaves astray, no one can guide. And I bear witness that there is no deity worthy of worship but Allah, the one having no partners associated with him. And I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his slave and his last messenger. Dear brothers and sisters, I'd like to remind you to fear Allah and to act with piety and righteousness, and to always be conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us in the Quran, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu taqullaha wa qulu qawlan sadida yuslih lakum a'malakum wa yaghfir lakum dhunubakum. وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ فَقَدْ فَازَ فَوْزًا عَظِيمًا. All you who believe, fear Allah, and always say a word directed to the right, that He may make your conduct whole and sound and forgive your sins. He that obeys Allah and His Messenger has already attained the highest achievement. InshaAllah, today I want to talk about a couple of ayahs from Surah Al-Nahl. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَأَوْحَى رَبُّكَ إِلَى النَّحْلِ أَنِ اتَّخِذِي مِنَ الْجِبَالِ بُيُوتًا وَمِنَ الشَّجَرِ وَمِمَّا يَعْرِشُونَ ثم كلي من كل الثمرات فاسلكي سبل ربك ذللا يخرج من بطونها شراب مختلفا ألوانه فيه شفاء للناس إن في ذلك لآية لقوم يتفكرون. And your Lord has revealed to the bee, saying, make hives in the mountains and in the trees and in what they build. Then eat of all the fruits and walk in the ways of your Lord submissively. There comes forth from within it a beverage of many colors in which there is a healing for men. Most surely there is a sign in this for people who reflect. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us the example of the honeybee, and He wants us to reflect on this example of the honeybee. So I want to spend today's pulpit, inshallah, talking about a little bit about the honeybee. And the first thing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions is that He reveals to the bee that it can make its homes in the mountains and in the trees. And if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not give it that final allowance and in what they build, then we would not be able to farm bees. We wouldn't have any bee farms. We would have to search for honey in the mountains and the trees just like the bears do. But because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells them to make their homes in what man builds, we're able to farm them and get abundant honey from them. So that's the first blessing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions here. But really what I want to get into is a hadith from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this hadith is found in Musnad Imam Ahmad. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, by the one in whose hands is the soul of Muhammad, the believer is like a bee, which eats that which is pure and wholesome, and lays that which is pure and wholesome, and when it lands on something, it does not break or ruin it. So the Prophet said that the believer is like a bee, and he listed three things. The first thing that he listed, how is the believer like a bee? The bee eats well. It chooses a good, fresh, clean, pure flower. It won't touch a flower that's been visited by another hive or by another bee. So it looks only for that which is pure. So as believers, we should also look for the blessings in good and pure things. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَكُلُوا مِمَّا رَزَقَكُمُ اللَّهُ حَلَالًا طَيِّبًا وَاشْكُرُوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ إِن كُنتُمْ إِيَّاهُ تَعْبُدُونَ. Therefore, eat of what Allah has given you, lawful and good things, and give thanks for Allah's favor if Him you serve. Allah orders His believing servants to eat from the good and lawful things that He has provided, and to give thanks to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for that. So our food should be pure, our income should be pure, our clothing, everything that we do, everything that we have, everything that we derive should come from pure and lawful services, from pure and lawful sources. The second thing that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned in this hadith is that it lays that which is pure and wholesome. We know that the honey that a bee produces is pure and wholesome and has health benefits, as was mentioned in the verse that we started with. يَخْرُجُ مِنْ بُطُونِهَا شَرَابٌ مُخْتَلِفٌ أَلْوَانُهُ فِيهِ شِفَاءٌ لِلنَّاسِ. There comes forth from within it a beverage of many colors in which there is healing for men. And in Sahih Bukhari, we read that the Prophet ﷺ said that honey is a remedy for every illness. And the Quran is a remedy for all illness of the mind. Therefore, I recommend to you both remedies, the Quran and honey. And just as the honeybee produces that which is pure, so must the believer. How do we produce what is pure? We do it first by having pure and lawful earnings, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَنْفِقُوا مِنْ طَيِّبَاتِ مَا كَسَبْتُمْ وَمِمَّا أَخْرَجْنَا لَكُمْ مِنَ الْأَرْضِ. Oh, you who believe, spend benevolently of the good things that you earn and of what we have brought forth for you out of the earth. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us to spend in the way of Allah, not from unlawful earnings, but from the good and the halal earnings. Before we can spend from the good things, we have to earn from the good things. So our income can't be from impermissible sources, like interest or selling alcohol. We can't misrepresent items when we sell them. We can't cheat others to make our income. Producing that which is pure could also be alluding to our offspring. If you think about the dua of the Prophet Nuh, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that he made against his people in Surat Nuh, he said, وَقَالَ نُوحُ رَبِّ لَا تَذَرْ عَلَى الْأَرْضِ مِنَ الْكَافِرِينَ دَيَّارًا إِنَّكَ إِنْ تَذَرْهُمْ يُضِلُّوا عِبَادَكَ وَلَا يَلِدُوا إِلَّا فَاجِرًا كَفَّارًا. And Nuh said, My Lord, leave not upon the land any dweller from among the unbelievers. For surely if you leave them, they will lead your servants astray, and they will not beget any but immoral and ungrateful children. So producing that which is pure means that we must call people to Islam and teach our children a proper understanding of the religion so that they in turn can produce religious, moral, and grateful children. The third characteristic of the bee that the Prophet ﷺ mentioned in the hadith is that when it lands on something, it doesn't break it or ruin it. وَوَقَعَتْ فَلَمْ تَكْسِبْ وَلَمْ تُفْسِدْ. The bee, even before it takes nectar from a flower, it actually gives the flower pollen. So it takes nectar from the flower without harming it, and it gives pollen to the flower, which benefits it. And when the bee sits on the flower to get the nectar, it has to sit on a very delicate part of the flower. So rather than sit on the flower and put its full weight on that delicate part of the flower and risk breaking it, it actually kind of hovers up on that point. So it's not putting its full weight on it, so it doesn't risk breaking it. Now, in our relationships with people, we give and we get. In our marriages, in our relationships with our parents, our friends, our children, our employers, and our employees, we have relationships where we give and we get. But the bee gives much more than it gets, and it gives us more than it gets, and it goes out of its way not to harm the flower. So we have to ask ourselves, do we demand too much from other people? Do we demand too much from our spouses, from our parents, from our children? Do we demand so much that we risk reaching a breaking point? Or do we give just as much as we get? Do we benefit others as much as they benefit us? You know that the bee, when it's choosing a flower, it can sense when another bee has visited the flower. If another bee has visited the flower and taken nectar from that flower, the bee won't touch the flower, otherwise it could ruin it. Rather than take the blessing or ruin the blessing of another bee, it will look for its blessing in another flower. And when it finds a location that is abundant in flowers, it doesn't keep it a secret. It goes back to the hive, returns to the hive, and it does what's called a waggle dance. So what's the waggle dance? In this waggle dance, the bee does a vibration. So it vibrates for a length of time, and the length of that vibration indicates to the other bees the distance that they have to travel to reach the flower bed. And then it walks across the honeycombs in an angle that tells the other bees what angle in relation to the sun they need to fly to find the flower bed. In this way, the bee is able to give coordinates up to about 6 kilometers away to the other bees of where to find this flower bed, find this abundant blessings. And so it shares that benefit, right? It doesn't keep it a secret. Similarly, the believers should look for blessings without trying to take someone else's blessings. Near my house, there's a fairly busy corner. And in that corner, there was an Exxon gas station, a 7-Eleven, a CVS, and a Carter Drugs. And there was one corner that was vacant. And in that vacant lot, a Quick Check gas station and convenience store opened. And it took some of the customers from the other gas station and they put that other gas station out of business and that gas station closed, then it probably took some of the market share from the 7-Eleven. And then in that location where the gas station was, a Walgreens pharmacy opened. And that forced the Carver Drugs out of business, and they probably also took some of the share of the CVS pharmacy. And so everybody is looking for their blessings, but at the same time, they're harming others, right? But the bee doesn't harm others when it looks for its blessings. So we need to try to be like the bee and be thankful for the blessings that we have and look for additional blessings in that which is good and pure without causing a detriment to others. So how do we look for blessings and increase the blessings? The first way is through gratitude. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَدَرَبَ اللَّهُ مَثَلًا قَرْيَةً كَانَتْ آمِنَةً مُطْمَئِنَّةً يَأْتِيهَا رِزْقُهَا رَغَدًا مِنْ كُلِّ مَكَانٍ فَكَفَرَتْ بِأَنْعُمِ اللَّهِ فَأَذَاقَهَا اللَّهُ لِبَاسَ الْجُوعِ وَالْخَوْفِ بِمَا كَانُوا يَصْنَعُونَ. And Allah gives the example of a township. It was secure and peaceful, its provision coming to it in abundance from every place, but its people became ungrateful to the favors of Allah. So Allah made it taste extreme hunger and famine and fear because of what they did. Conversely, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in the Quran, وَإِذْ تَأَذَّنَ رَبُّكُمْ لَإِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ وَلَإِنْ كَفَرْتُمْ إِنَّ عَذَابِي لَشَدِيدٌ. And when your Lord made it known, if you are grateful, I will certainly give you more. And if you are ungrateful, my chastisement is truly severe. And gratitude is knowing that whatever we have is from Allah. وَمَا بِكُمْ مِنْ نِعْمَةٍ فَمِنَ اللَّهِ. And whatever favor is bestowed upon you, it is from Allah. You know, a few years ago when my son was younger, he asked me for some fruit snacks. So I gave him a bag of fruit snacks from the box, and he opened it and he started to eat from it. And as he's eating from it, I asked, can I have one? He said, no, these are my fruit snacks. I told him, but I just gave them to you. Can I have them? And he insisted, no, these are my fruit snacks, they're not yours. Okay? And this is the condition of man. We forget that our belongings were given to us by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we must strive to remember the blessings and favors that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed upon us. The second way to increase your blessings is by seeking Allah's forgiveness. In the tafsir of Surah Nuh, it states that a man came to Imam al-Hasan and complained to him about a drought. And the Imam gave him an advice. He told him, pray to Allah for forgiveness. And then another man came to him and complained to him of poverty. And he gave him the same advice, pray to Allah for forgiveness. And then another man came and said to him, pray to Allah to bless me with a child. And he gave him the same advice, ask Allah for forgiveness. And then a fourth man came to him and he complained to him that his garden was dry. And he said to him, pray to Allah for forgiveness. And so somebody came to the Imam and asked him, he said, these people came to you with four different problems and you gave them all the same advice. Why was this? So the Imam said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Nuh, فَقُلْتُ اسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبَّكُمْ إِنَّهُ كَانَ غَفَّارًا يُرْسِلِ السَّمَاءَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِدْرَارًا وَيُمْدِدْكُمْ بِأَمْوَالٍ وَبَنِينَ وَيَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ جَنَّاتٍ وَيَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ أَنْهَارًا. Ask forgiveness from your Lord. Verily, He is all forgiving. He will send rain to you in abundance and give you increase in wealth and children and bestow on you gardens and bestow on you rivers. So if you want to increase your blessings, you get seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The third way to increase your blessings is through taqwa. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَوْ أَنَّ أَهْلَ الْقُرَى آمَنُوا وَاتَّقَوْا لَفَتَحْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ بَرَكَاتٍ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَلَكِنْ كَذَّبُوا فَأَخَذْنَاهُمْ بِمَا كَانُوا يَكْسِبُونَ. And if the people of the towns had believed and guarded against evil, taqwa is to guard against evil, we would certainly have opened up for them blessings from the heaven and the earth, but they rejected. So we overtook them for what they had earned. So how do we guard against evil? We guard against evil through the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, through prayers and through fasting. The fourth way to increase your blessings is by keeping good company. There is a hadith that narrated by Abu Hurairah where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that Allah the Exalted has teams of angels who go about on the road seeking those who remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when they find some people remembering Allah, they will call to one another and say, come to what you are looking for. And they surround them with their wings till the space between them and the low sky is fully covered. Allah, the Exalted and Glorious, asks them, although He is all best informed about everything, why? What are my slaves saying? And the angels say, they are glorifying you. They're making tasbih and tahmid and takbir. And he asks, have they seen me? And the angels reply, no, they have not seen you. And he asks, how would they act if they were to see me? And they reply, if they were to see you, they would engage more earnestly in worshiping and glorifying you and would extol you more. And then Allah asks, what do they beg of me? And they say, they beg of you your Jannah. And Allah asks, have they seen my Jannah? And they say, no, they have not seen it. And Allah asks, what would they do if they saw the Jannah? And they said that they would be intensely eager for it. Then the angels say, and they seek your protection. And he asks, what do they seek my protection against? And they say, from the hellfire. And Allah asks, have they seen the hellfire? And they say, no, they haven't seen the hellfire. And Allah asks, what would they do if they saw the hellfire? And they say that they would be seeking more for your protection from the hellfire. They would beg your forgiveness. And he says, I call to you to witness that I hereby grant pardon to them and confer upon them what they ask for and grant them protection against what they seek protection from. And one of the angels says, our Rabb, there is amongst them such and such slave who does not belong to the assembly of those who are participating in your remembrance. He passed by them and sat down with them. He says, I also grant him pardon because they are people by virtue of whom their associates will not be unfortunate. So if you want to increase your blessings, find a good group of friends. Sit with those group of friends that remember Allah constantly, and that will remind you to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us all like the bee, the mu'minins like the bee, who eat from the pure and give that from that which is pure, and do not harm others when looking for blessings and are increasing blessings. بسم الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. Very quickly before I end, because I'm about out of time, just want to give a quick reminder about charity. Just mention one verse from Surah Al-Baqarah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, مَثَلُ الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ أَمْوَالَهُمْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ كَمَثَلِ حَبَّةٍ أَنْبَتَتْ سَبْعَ سَنَابِلَ فِي كُلِّ سُنْبُلَةٍ مِائَةُ حَبَّةٍ وَاللَّهُ يُضَاعِفُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ وَاللَّهُ وَاسِعٌ عَلِيمٌ. The parable of those who spend their property in the way of Allah is as the parable of a grain growing 7 ears with 100 grains in every ear. And Allah multiplies for whom He pleases, and Allah is ample giving and knowing. Let this verse be a reminder for us that when we give for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whether that be money, whether that be services, whether that be a kind word, anything that we do for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's not something that is lost. It is something that will come back to benefit you, and the benefits will multiply in ways that you can't enumerate. So always remember to give to the masajid, to remember those that are less fortunate than you, and to make dua for those that are less fortunate than you. I'll end with that. لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها لها ما كثرت عليها ما كسبت. ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا أو أخطأنا. ربنا ولا تحمل علينا إصرا كما حملته على الذين من قبلنا. ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به. واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا. أنت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. اللهم اهدنا فيمن هديت وعافنا فيمن عافيت. وتولنا فيما توليت وبارك لنا فيما اعطيت واغفر لنا واصرف عنا شر ما قضيت فانك ربي ولا يبقى عليك وانه لا يذل من وليت ولا يعز من عاديت تباركت ربنا وتعاليت. عباد الله ان الله يامر بالعدل والاحسان وايتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله العظيم يذكركم واشكروه يزدكم واستغفروه يغفر لكم واتقوا الله لكم من امركم مخرجا واقم الصلاه.
الله أكبر الله أكبر صلى الله عليه وسلم أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله.
This is a final prayer. Allahu Akbar. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Ar-Rahmanir Rahim. Maliki Yawmiddin. إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين.
آمين.
إن في اختلاف الليل والنهار وما خلق الله في السماوات والأرض لآيات لقوم يتقون. إن الذين لا يرجون لقاءنا ورضوا بالحياة الدنيا واطمأنوا بها والذين هم عن آياتنا غافلون أولئك مأواهم النار بما كانوا يكسبون. إن الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات يهديهم ربهم بإيمانهم تجري من تحتهم الأنهار في جنات النعيم دعواهم فيها سبحانك اللهم وتحيتهم فيها سلام وآخر دعواهم أن الحمد لله رب العالمين. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين.
آمين.
قال رب إني دعوت قومي ليلا ونهارا فلم يزدهم دعائي إلا فرارا وإني كلما دعوتهم لتغفر لهم جعلوا أصابعهم في آذانهم واستغشوا ثيابهم وأصروا واستكبروا استكبارا ثم إني دعوتهم جهارا ثم إني أعلنت لهم وأسررت لهم إسرارا فقلت استغفروا ربكم إنه كان غفارا يرسل السماء عليكم مدرارا ويمددكم بأموال وبنين ويجعل لكم جنات ويجعل لكم أنهارا. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. إن شاء الله cooking our food tonight is the family night and everyone will have the family about 7 PM إن شاء الله right here. We'll have the family night. Also anyone who's parking in the parking lot, please park in the right places because it will affect the other cars for coming in. Also, inshallah, we have, just remember the date, June 19th will be the next hearing. Put on the calendar to be there, inshallah, for 7, 6 p.m. will be better, inshallah, to be there. the Qurbani and Uliya is open now because as we know June inshallah will be Eid. So we're trying to get all the funds together so we can have the animals in India and Africa. So you can go to the website and make the, if you want more sheep or you want to buy a cow, please do so. The link is there to make the payment inshallah. Just as well.